Well, you know something? I have something money can't buy. I have you. And Connecticut today had an election, not an auction. To the people of Connecticut, I have a very simple message. Thank you. Thank you for putting your trust, your confidence, and your support in me. I am grateful, as is my family, and thank you for letting me keep fighting for you. Every day in this campaign, someone said to me, Washington isn't listening. And I'll tell you, I'm listening, and I will make Washington listen to Connecticut. I am proud to have spent a lifetime taking on some of the most difficult fights, some of the toughest battles, against utility companies when they overcharged us, pharmaceutical drug companies when they raised their prices, big tobacco, internet providers, and I want to take those fights to Washington, putting Connecticut first, making people a priority. And tonight I reach out to every person in Connecticut, Republican or Democrat, and independents, because there are very, very difficult challenges ahead. We have to put middle-class families first again, and that means middle-class tax cuts now. We need to help our small businesses, and that means giving them the tools they need to expand and grow jobs and take away the obstacles to their expansion and job creation. We need to fight for small businesses in Connecticut and around the nation now. And we have to encourage green technology. Green technologies and green jobs. Those are essential to our state and our nation's future, and we need to control spending and cut the deficit and reduce the debt, but we shouldn't do it on the backs of our senior citizens or our middle class. And I will fight. I will fight for them as well. To my opponent, I extend a hand after a tough and difficult fight. And to Mrs. McMahon and Republicans across the state, I say I welcome your help. I urge you to join in this work ahead. And I will reach out to every person in the state of Connecticut, whether you were with me or not. We are all in these fights together. My door is open, as it has been over 20 years, and I will continue to travel this state as I did today, to our towns and cities, our parades, our fairs, to your backyards and your living rooms, to everywhere that I can listen to you, because in 20 years, my best ideas and my best energy have come from the people of Connecticut, and I can tell you, I will always put you first, and I will always be in your corner. Let me say, I would not be here tonight if it were not for my family. To Matthew, Second Lieutenant Matthew Blumenthal, Michael, David, and Claire, and really made it possible, and I mean really made it possible for me to be here today, my wife Cynthia. And to those of you who may have said over time, after you heard Cynthia talk to you, why isn't she running instead of you? I am very glad she was not my competitor in this race. So, to every one of you, the work is now beginning. We need to fight for the middle class and ordinary men and women who are struggling and hurting in this country and in our state, struggling for jobs, struggling to stay in their homes, struggling to make ends meet. We have a lot of work to do. We have a lot of challenges ahead. We're more than equal to them. And as a nation and as a state, we need to continue these battles. I pledge to you that I will fight for Connecticut first, last, and always. Thank you so much for all that you have done. And thank you for making this night possible. God bless you, and God bless America. Thank you so much. Thank